Okay, so we'll discuss the complete paper again once again. So before starting up the class. So first question is what? Weaving is done on the device called?
Looms.
It's called done on the device called as in? Looms.
Looms.
Right? What is the weaving process? What is the meaning of weaving? Lohini?
Weaving means like it's a machine which weaves our clothes.
Jay?
Sir, interlacing two yarns and triangles to make the fabrics.
Interlacing of the two, the process of interlacing of two yarns. A triangle to each other to form the fabric is called as in weaving. So how many types of weaving process are there? How many types of looms are there?
Two types.
Two types. What are the two types, Yadarth? Yadarth, what are the two different looms are there? Two different loom industries. Handloom industry.
And the power loom industry.
And the power loom industry. Ashwath, you can turn on your video. Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
How was your test yesterday?
Sir, was there a test today, sir? I don't know.
Not today, yesterday's test.
Yesterday test. The math one, sir.
No, I'm asking about the science one.
1 minute, sir.
Okay, Ashwath, they have the question paper on the screen. You don't want to check again.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so what is an, we have two different loom industries. One is a hand loom industry. Another one is a power loom industries, right? In the hand loom industry, we'll use a human manpower for the weaving process. In the power loom industries, we'll use the machines for the weaving process. Yes? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good evening, Sriharsha. Sriharsha, you can turn on your video. Okay. So what about the next one? Llama and alpaca wool is obtained from. Okay. In the first question, we have three other options are there, right? So what is the takli, charka, and needles? What is the use of that? What is the use of takli, charka, and needles? That? Jaydeep, you can turn on your videos.
So they are used to spin the yarn from the wool and the cotton.
Generally, they are using for the spinning process, right? In the spinning process, converting from fiber to the yarn, we'll use the takli or charka and the needles. Only looms we'll use in the weaving process.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And what about the next question? First of all, how many are there in the last class when we are discussing about these topics, spinning and weaving? Just raise your hands in the Google, in the Zoom meeting. Yadarth, you are not there in the last class. Okay. So Yadarth and Lohini are absent in the last class. Okay. So llama and alpaca wool is obtained from. Have you discussed this question in the class?
Sir, I think so. We didn't discuss this question, sir.
We didn't discuss this question. Okay. So generally, these are the wool, right? Wool topic, I think we didn't finish. Okay, no problem. So what is the answer for this? Can you guess once?
Sir, sheep.
Sheep, good. So llama and alpaca is obtained from the sheep. So angora is also a one type of sheep, or a rabbit, yak, and a camel. So from all this, we will get the wool only, right? These are the different source of wool from the different animals. So what about the third one?
It is spinning.
The process of making yarn from fibers is called as an?
The spinning process.
Spinning process. Right? Already first one we discussed in the first question itself. Knitting we will discuss in today's class. And looming process also same, right? With the help of the power loom industries and the hand loom industries, that is the looming. What about the fourth one?
It is known as weaving.
Weaving. The process of arranging the two set of yarns together to make a fabric is called as in weaving. What about the answer for fifth one? Wait, Jaydeep, Sriharsha.
Sir?
Srihar, you can lower your hands. Everyone has to turn on your videos first. What is the answer for fifth one?
The one is cotton balls, sir.
The fruit of the cotton plant are called as in cotton balls. Then what is this mulberry leaves? Have you know this?
No, sir.
Silkworm is there, right? You know silkworm? Silk moth?
Yes, sir.
Silk moth will eat the mulberry leaves. And silk moth will lay the eggs on the mulberry leaves. So we'll discuss that one afterwards, okay? Next one, Lohini, what is the answer for 61?
Sir, I think it's C, silk side.
Hailey wants to present their gift, their friend her gift made of plant fiber. Which of the following will she select? She wants to gift her friend a plant fiber.
Plant fiber, jute bag?
Which one?
The A, jute bag.
Jute bag or silk? Silk is coming from the animals, right? That is from the silk moth. Woolen also will come from the animals only. So only plant fiber is here, jute. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
It's a jute answer. Next, Edar. So what is the answer for seventh?
The nylon.
Nylon?
Yes, sir.
So what about the remaining three?
Sir, cotton, jute and flax are natural fibers.
Good.
Flax is nylon. An artificial fiber.
Okay, good. Ashwath, have raised your hand.
Sir, can I also answer, sir?
Yeah, I will. Next question is only for you. So next question is for Ashwath only. Ashwath.
Sir.
So what is the answer for the eighth question?
Yes, sir.
First of all, read the question.
Sir, I think it is... Sir, it is silk, sir.
Read the question first.
Bujo, what is this? Went to a cloth shop. There he found a fabric which was smooth to touch. Had vibrant color and shine. The fabric could be silk, sir, I think, sir.
You think? Are you not 100% confident?
Sir?
Are you 100% confident this is an answer?
No, sir.
No. Why? What is the doubt in that?
Sir, I think
cotton. Whether cotton will have the shiny surface and vibrant color?
Sir?
Whether cotton will have the vibrant color and shiny surface?
No, sir.
Wool and jute?
No, sir.
Then obviously answer is silk only, right? The answer is silk. Whatever you said is correct. Okay, so any doubts in the 8 questions?
No, sir.
No, sir.
It's only easy one, right? Easy question paper. Only except the second one. Second question is out of the syllabus. Okay.
Okay.
So what is the last class homework I have given for you?
Sir, what is the difference between the thermosetting and the thermoplastic, sir?
Okay. So what is the difference between thermosetting and thermoplastic?
Sir, thermoplastic means it is the substance that becomes soft on heating and becomes hard on cooling. Whereas the thermosetting is the substance that becomes permanently rigid when heated.
Okay.
And the examples of the thermoplastic are acrylic, polystyrene, nylon, and the Teflon. The examples of the thermosetting are phenolic, epoxy resin, vinyl ester resin, and the cyanate ester. That's it, sir.
So, in the case of thermosetting, it cannot be molded or it cannot be soft upon heating. Right, we cannot change into one form to other form. But in the case of thermoplastic, if you heat that fiber, it will become soft, and if you cool again, it will become the hard mass. We can change the shape from one form to other form upon heating. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
That's all. What is the homework you have given in the last class?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, today, last class we discussed about the weaving process, right? Up to weaving, we discussed about the hand loom industry, power loom industries. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, today's homework for you is, write down, which district in Telangana is famous for the hand looms and power loom industries? Which district is famous in Telangana for the handloom and powerloom industries? Understanding? You have to find the short note on that district, why it is famous.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
So, what's your homework?
Which district is famous in Telangana for handloom and powerloom industry and why?
Yeah. Okay. So next we'll start about the knitting process. Suppose if you take the one cloth, any cloth.
Sir?
If you take the cloth and the socks.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, can you repeat the homework again?
Which district is famous for the handloom and powerloom industries in Telangana? You can unmute yourself and you can speak. Lohini.
No, sir. It's not enough.
Okay. Is it clear for first?
Yes, sir.
Ashwath? Ashwath, is it clear? You can unmute yourself, no problem.
Sir, tell the question. Can you tell if it is correct or wrong, sir?
Yeah.
Which industry is famous for
handloom
and power loom and
which district? Why? Which district is famous in Telangana for the handloom and power loom industry? Okay. So if you take the two different types of cloths, okay, first one is a take one cotton cloth, second one is a take one socks. Suppose if you remove one thread from the cotton cloth, what will happen?
It will become a ball,
I will ask you another way. Suppose if you want to remove one thread from the cotton cloth, whether it is a complete cloth will destroy or it will be like the same.
It will be like the same.
Same, right? Suppose if you remove the same thread from the socks, what will happen? The thread will come out continuously or it will come only for some
super length?
It will come continuously, right? Have you observed this one? Have you observed anytime this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because in the case of cloths, we will use the weaving process to make the fabric. But in the case of socks, we will use knitting process. Understanding? In the case of weaving, what we will do? We will use two different yarns, right? Or two yarns we will use.
Okay, sir.
Which are at right angle to each other. But in the case of knitting, you will use only one yarn.
Okay, sir.
Understanding?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. I'm
on. Clear? That's why if you remove one thread from the socks, the thread will come out continuously. But in the case of cotton cloth, it will not come in that way, right? It is very difficult to remove the thread from the cotton cloth.
Yes,
and it will break easily because
it's very fragile.
Yeah, it is because we are using two yarns in the cotton piece, that is the weaving process. But in the case of socks, we'll use the knitting process. In the knitting process, we'll use only one yarn.
Okay, sir.
Can you see the picture?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Drona Hansh, good evening. You can turn on your video once.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, you can introduce yourself once.
Yes. Hello, everyone. My name is Drona Hansh, and I study in St. Paul's High School. I'm in 6th grade.
Okay, good. So this is your first class, right?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah. So you can continue from here. Afterwards, in the last 10 minutes, I'll discuss it with you from the starting onwards, okay?
Yes.
Yeah. So is it clear? What is the knitting process? So we'll go for line. Yeah. Jay? Yeah, someone is
asking. Yes, sir.
Can you go? Sir, can you go?
Who is that first?
Sir, I'm Harsha.
Yeah, Harsha. Harsha, you can turn on your video, right? So when you are present in the class, you should turn on your videos now. Yeah, Harsha.
Sir, can you go sum up?
Sorry? I didn't understand what you are saying, Harsha.
Sir, can you go sum up?
You want to slide up for what?
Okay, sir. You can scroll down.
I think you are not present in the last class, right? Harsha?
Sir, presented, sir.
Presented, okay. So, okay, we will continue here. So, what is the knighting?
The knighting is the process used to make a fabric by using one yarn.
Okay. So, suppose if you take the sweater also, it will happen. It will be done with the help of the knighting process. Okay. We will prepare the sweaters or socks and like this with the help of the knighting or knitting process. So you can see here, right?
Yes, sir.
There is a one thread.
Yes, sir.
There is a thread. So from the help of this, they're making into the socks. If you remove one thread from the socks, the thread will come out continuously.
Okay.
So who is the father of our nation?
Mahatma Gandhi.
Mahatma Gandhi, right? So have you seen this picture anywhere before?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What is this?
What is the chakra?
Chakra.
What is this?
Chakra.
What is the use of chakra?
It is used in the spinning process.
It is used in the spinning process. So what is the meaning of khadi? Do you know what is a khadi?
No, sir.
No.
No.
You don't know about the khadi. Okay, today's homework, you find out what is the meaning of khadi, okay? Understanding. Find out what is the meaning of khadi and what is the importance of that. Not done. I'll ask you tomorrow again, everyone.
Khadi is Indian clothes, sir. At the British rule, Mahatma Gandhi advised every Indian to not wear imported clothes from the British and only wear Indian clothes, commonly called khadi.
Drona, right?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, so correct. So we have to wear the natural fiber cloths instead of wearing the foreign countries cloths and all. So that is the Khadi commission and everything is there. So first, everyone, 5 or 6 people are there in the class, right? First find out what is the definition of Khadi and what is the central government company is there, what is the organization and all. Khadi and village commission is there. So what is the Khadi and village commission, what is the role of that? Okay, that is your homework. Okay. So first we'll discuss about the cotton. So we'll discuss how the cotton will grow and everything from the now onwards. So first discuss about the cotton, in that growth of the cotton. So first soil is important, right, for the growth of the cotton plant. So what type of soil is better for the growth of cotton plant?
Black soil.
Black soil or alluvial soil. Okay. Suppose, so you have the flower pots in your home, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So if today you go and check, just check it, whether you have the black soil or red soil in your flower plots. Okay.
Okay.
So in your garden or in your house, flower plots will be there, right? Which type of soil you are using in that? Whether it is a black soil or red soil, I'll ask you tomorrow what type of soil it is.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So for the healthy growth of the cotton, generally they will use the black soil. Okay. In the black soil, the cotton growth is very good. So generally, where is this black soil present in India? In the Deccan and the Malwa plateau of the Gujarat. Okay, have you seen the black soil first?
Yes, sir.
So this is the picture I have shown you, right?
Yes, sir.
So that is a black soil. Suppose if you are going for the lake area, so you'll find out the black soil there also. So generally, black soil will have the high moisture content. Okay. So best growth of cotton will be done in the black soil because the black soil will contain the large amount of moisture. What is the meaning of moisture? That is the water. So black soil always will hold the large amount of water. So water is only important for the growth of the plant, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The cotton plant will grow better in the black soil. And it will have the fine texture and the clay in nature. So this is all about the black soil.
Okay, sir.
So the, what are the components present in the black soil? Generally, it will contain more amount of iron, lime, magnesium, and aluminum. So these are the four components present in the black soil. So black soil contain what are the minerals?
Iron, lime, magnesia, and alumina.
So cotton also grow well in the light and alluvial soil. Along with the black soil, cotton also grow better in the alluvial soil. Okay. So in India, which place is famous for the cotton cultivation?
Maharashtra, Gujarat, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, and Madhya Pradesh.
Okay.
Okay.
And one more homework for you is find out top 10 states in India for the cotton cultivation. These are a lot of fun activities for you. Okay, it's not a homework. This is a general knowledge for you. Okay, find out top 10 states in India in the cotton cultivation.
Okay, sir.
So almost I have given already here itself. Maharashtra, Gujarat, Haryana, Punjab. But the order will vary. Either it will come first or it will come second or third. Like that. Is it okay?
It is okay, sir.
Okay. Can you tell me which one is the southern states?
Tamil Nadu.
Tamil Nadu is a southern state. Okay, good.
Madhya Pradesh.
Madhya Pradesh is a southern state?
No, sir.
No. Drona, Ajarda has to say where is Gujarat?
Excuse me, sir.
Gujarat is a north state.
Not sir.
Okay. So only Tamil Nadu is the southern state in India out of these given states.
Okay.
Okay, Maharashtra you can see on the left side. If you take the Telangana map, Maharashtra will be there on the northwest, right? So remaining you can find out on the India map, okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
So what, which soil is better for the cultivation of cotton?
The black soil.
Black soil and alluvial soil. Two soils are better for the cultivation of cotton. So next one, climatic conditions. So what are the different climatic conditions required for the growth of the cotton plant? So what are the climatic conditions required for growth of cotton plant?
Plenty of sunshine, preferably mild, cool and dry climate.
The temperature of 21 to 27 degrees Celsius. Okay. Do you know what is the body temperature? What is the human body temperature?
Sir, 96 to 97.
Sir,
97 degrees Celsius.
97. That is not Celsius.
That is 38 degrees Celsius.
Good.
Degrees, sir.
Who is this? 38.
Sir, it is 97. Sorry, 98 degrees. 98.4 to 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit and 38 Celsius, sir.
Yeah.
38 degrees Celsius.
Very good, Ashwath. I think Ashwath, right?
Sir.
Ashwath, good. Human body temperature is around 37 to 38 degrees Celsius. Understanding. Human body temperature is around
37 to 38 Celsius.
But in the case of foreign heats, what is the answer?
98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. 98.6
is the normal temperature of human body. Suppose you are suffering from fever. What they will say, doctor? Your fever is 100 degrees Celsius. Or they will say, 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Or they will say 102 degrees Fahrenheit.
Right? We will have high temperature.
Mild fever, and if it is above 100, it's high fever, sir.
Yeah, good. Suppose you have the 102 fever, the doctor will say it's a high fever, right? Because the normal human body temperature is only 98.6. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
So human body temperature in case of dogs, they will measure in the Fahrenheit.
Okay, sir.
The help of thermometer, right? Okay, so what is the climatic conditions required for the growth of cotton? It should be plenty of sunshine should be required. Next, there should be mild climate. It should not be completely
warm
or should not be completely hot.
And the temperature should be around, warm cool night, sir.
Okay, and the temperature is around 21 degree centigrade to 27 degree centigrade. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So what about the rainfall?
Rainfall of 60 centimeters to 80 centimeters.
The rainfall required for healthy growth of cotton is 60 centimeters to 80 centimeters. So next one is the planting season. When we will plant the cotton plants first? So generally cotton should be planted before the onset of monsoon. What is the monsoon here?
Monsoon and rainy season, sir.
Good. Monsoon is a
rainy season,
right?
Yes, sir.
So, have you seen this time when the monsoon is coming? Have you seen the news? Generally, nowadays, IMD.
Sir, in the Rabi season, sir.
Yeah. Do you know what is IMD? Indian Meteorological Department. Do you know some people will advise before the cyclone is coming or rain is going to come, right? Some people will forecast the weather.
Yes, sir.
So that is the IMD department, Indian Meteorological Department. Okay. So find out when is the monsoon is coming to the India this year. Okay.
Sir, I think July that time, sir.
So already they told in the news yesterday or day before yesterday, when is the onset of monsoon in India this year? Just to check the news also, okay? Am I giving more homework for you?
No, sir. Sir, can you repeat the last homework once?
So find out the date of onset of monsoon in India this year. Generally, onset of monsoon will happen in the June month, right? So tomorrow is the June 1st. So first monsoon will come into the Kerala, right? Okay.
Yes, sir. It also will come slowly, but day to day it will become more slow.
Yeah, first monsoon will come to the Kerala. From there, it will advance to the North India. Okay. So generally, cotton plants will be planted before the
onset of moon.
Because before the starting of the monsoon season in India. Means in the month of June. Right? In the month of June, they will start planting of the cotton plants. Okay? Any doubts?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Then what about the cultivation? So first they plant the seeds. First they will put the seeds in the soil. Afterwards, the monsoon will come. So with the help of the water, the seeds will grow into the plants. Right?
They will use fertilizers.
Yeah. In between the cultivation process, they will use fertilizers or some pesticides to remove the weeds and all. Okay. So next one is the cultivation. Yeah.
Sir, can I tell you one trick to remember